गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। माय नेम इज अनमंजना सिंह, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सिविल डिपार्टमेंट, जोबल इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट डिजाइन एंड ड्राइंग ऑफ रेनफोर्स्ड कॉन्क्रीट स्ट्रक्चर्स। द टॉपिक इज व्हाट इज द सिलेबस एज पर जीएन टू काकीनाडा। सी द गो टू नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। सी दैट इज द डिजाइनिंग and drawing of reinforced concrete structure. What is the main objective of this subject, this course? What is the objectives? What is the outcomes? See, different this subject mainly design and drawing of reinforced concrete structures. The main objectives, see, the different types of design philosophies. The main objective, any member will be designed different types of philosophies there, different types of methodologies is there. What is the methodology is going on, that is the learning, that is the main objective of this subject. Another one is the concepts of design of flexural members. Design. What are the concepts are taken for as per design? Any element, any structure element. What are the concepts are taken? Learning the this objects and understand concepts of shear, bond, and torsion. This is the concepts. What are the concepts of the learning these objects? Another one, different types of compression members and design. What are the different types of compression members? Compression member is nothing but a column. The best example. These are the objectives of another one is different types of footings and their design. Every structural element will be learning how to design the element. These are the main objects. You have to learning the student these course learning objects. These are the learning the different structural element, how to design, how to drawing the, how to design the, what are the methodologies, what are the concepts. That is the main thing, main objectives of this subject. Another one is course outcomes. This course, this subject will be learning up to entire subject. What are the outcomes will be. These are the C work on different types of design philosophies. What are the different types of methodologies will be? This is the student will be able. What are the different types of methodologies and analysis and design members with detailing? What are this is the outcome? How to design the member? How to design the structural element? How to detailing the structural element and what are the shear, what is the bond, what is the torsion, how to design these members in entire this subject and different types of compression members and footings, how to design the element, how to follow the instructions, what are the concepts of designing of this structural elements, how to design the concrete structure. What are the methodologies following different types of methodologies for the designing any structural element in concrete structures? First, see the unit. Totally, both are overall units, entire units, totally 60 units for as per syllabus for JN2 Kakinada. Unit 1, that is introduction. See, these are the unit 1, two philosophies are there. First one, working stress method and image state design. These are the two philosophies. These are the two methodologies. First unit is discuss about the these two methodologies. Another one, first concept. This is the methodology. What are the methodologies are there? How to each methodology? How to design the structural element for this first unit? Design of beams. This is the beams. Singly reinforced. Different types of beams are there. Singly reinforced beam and doubly reinforced beam. these beams are designed in unit 1. First unit 1, different methodology. First study the how what are the methodologies, how to draw the element, structural element. Now these are the see for unit 1. Another concept is elastic theory. This is the working stress method is oldest method. That is the old working stress method is the oldest method. That is the elastic theory. That means the main concept of working stress method, the elastic theory is same as Hooke's law. That is stress is directly proportional to strain. This is the same concept of working stress method. Design constants and modular ratio, nodal axis, design of singly and doubly reinforced beams. These are the working stress method using these parameters is coming. First, I will discuss this methodology, working stress methodology. This is the same as Hooke's law. That is means Hooke's law means stress is directly proportional to strain. The main concept of working stress method. These are the sections are there. They discuss later what is nodal axis, what is the modular ratio, what are the design constants. These are the explain later. Another one is what is the balanced section, what is the under reinforced section, what is over reinforced section. So this means totally three types of sections: balanced section, under reinforced section, and over reinforced section. Balanced section means these two materials, concrete and reinforcement. Reinforcement and concrete. These two materials mainly balanced. What are the compressive concrete gives compressive stresses and the reinforcement gives tensile stresses. If both are working simultaneously, that is called balanced section. Both concrete and reinforced materials both simultaneously work acting on the load. That means that is the balanced section. Concrete and reinforcement, these two materials work from simultaneously, that is called balanced section. Next, what is the under reinforced section? Under reinforced section means, that is the under means less reinforcement. We have provide less reinforcement sections. That is called under reinforced section. This is the under reinforced section is preferred, but the failure will be occur. Under reinforced beams, these are the beams, the structure will be gradually failed, gradually develop the cracks and gradually failure the particular structural element. This under reinforcement will be not preferred for the design of beams. Why? Because the structure will be gradually fail the structural element like a beam. Under reinforcement means less reinforcement will be provided. That is called under reinforced section. Under reinforced section. That is the that means of under reinforced section. And another one is over reinforced. That means over means that is the extra reinforcement will be provided. Extra reinforcement will be provided. The structure will be suddenly collapse. The structure will be suddenly collapse. The over reinforcement beams are not to give the information. Over reinforced sections suddenly collapse the structure. This is the over reinforced section very dangerous. Not to design this sections. So the over reinforced is better than under reinforced section is better. Comparison is under reinforced over reinforced comparison. Under reinforcement will be preferred. Over reinforcement not preferred. Why? Because the over reinforced section design entirely structure suddenly collapse. Not give the information. Failure information, not give the information that over reinforced sections. These three parameters are there: balanced section and under reinforced section. and over-reinforced section. Maximum preferred for balanced section and under-reinforced section. So these are the first unit for the working stress methodology. See, for a singly reinforced and available doubly reinforced beams. Beams are two types, singly and singly reinforced beams and doubly reinforced beams. See the picture, what is singly, what is doubly. Beams are beam have two zones, compression zone and tension zone. Have to provide reinforcement only compression zone, that is the single reinforced section. What is doubly reinforced beams? Doubly reinforced beams, both compression zone and tension zone will be provide reinforcement, that is called doubly reinforced sections. This is the difference between singly and doubly reinforced beams. Another one, limit state design. What is the limit state design concepts and the basic statical principles, characteristics of loads, characteristic strength, partial load and safety factors, respective stress strain curve for cold worked deformed bars and the mild steel bars, assumptions in limit state design, stress block parameters, limiting moment of resistance. This is another one. First, now following this methodology, limit state design will be nowadays following this methodology, limit state design. These are the basic principles and design characteristics. What are the concepts of limit state design? We have learning those things, partial load and safety factors, and stress strain curve about deformed bars and mild steel bars. Stress strain curve. We will see the next class. These parameters will be learned in next class. Assumptions also taken for a limit state design. What are the assumptions? What are the this design or what are the assumptions are will be taken? And what are the block diagrams for a stress strain block diagrams and a limiting moment of resistance? That means limiting moment of resistance. That means moment maximum bending moment. That is the limiting moment is nothing but the bending moment. These are the unit one. This is the unit one for discuss about methodologies. What are the methodologies how to design the structural elements, just like the columns, beams, slabs, these are things. See, last all units, that is from unit 2 to unit 6, are to be taught in limit state design. See, only first unit, A point only working stress method, that only beams are designed for only working stress method. Remaining unit 2 to unit 6, entire units are used for only limit state design. Nowadays, why? Because nowadays used for this limit state design, any structural element for RCC structures. Okay, see that is the first unit. Another one, unit 2, design for lecturer, limit state analysis for the design of single reinforced sections and effective depth, moment of resistance, double reinforced flange sections T and L beams sections, minimum depth for a given capacity, limiting percentage of steel, minimum tension reinforcement, maximum flexural steel, design of flange sections, effective width of flange, behavior analysis and design. Unit 2, that is the beams, singly and doubly reinforced sections, and the flange sections also given. These are the different types of beams. Flange section means T beam, L beam. These are the flange sections. See, beams are the shape maximum used for rectangular shape, and this is rectangular shape, circular shape. Sorry. Only rectangular shape will be used. Evidently, maximum rectangular shape beams are used, and flanged beams are nothing but T and L beams, T beam and L beam. These are the flanged beams. This is the second unit, entire limit state analysis for designing single reinforced and double reinforced sections and flanged beams. Just like flanged beams means A beam and L beam. These are analysis and design. This is the second unit, go to third unit or the next unit. See, design for shear, torsion, and bond. This is the limit state design analysis for third unit. design of formwork for beams and slabs. Another one, limit design for serviceability. See the third unit entire discussion about the torsion, bond, and shear will be designed as per any standard corrosion provisions. Simply supported and continuous beams. These are the used for third unit also, just like beams for simply supported and continuous beams detailing. This third unit as per code provisions and formwork design of for formwork for beams and slabs. Formwork means nothing but shuttering. Shuttering work also will be discussed for third unit and serviceability also discussed. The serviceability will be designed for third unit. Another one is fourth unit, nothing but slabs. You know, different types of slabs, one way slab and two way slab. These two slabs will be designed for RCC structures. Different discuss about the RC. Another go to next slide. I will explain about unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, unit 4, unit 5, unit 6, up to 6 units. See the pictures and we'll explain. See unit 5. Design of compression members. That means effective. That means columns. Effective length of column. Design of short and long columns. Under axial loads, unaxial bending, and biaxial bending. Braced on and unbraced columns. IS4 provisions. These are the columns. There is nothing but compression member is nothing but columns. The effective length will be taken for two types of columns: short column and long columns. Axial loads, unaxial loads, and biaxial loads. Means what is axial or what is unaxial, what is biaxial. Axial means column center point will be act the load, that is called axial load. Unaxial means some distance the load acting from column center to some distance, that is eccentricity, that is called unaxial. Unaxial bending and biaxial bending, these conditions are used for design of compression members. Another one is 6th unit footings. You know, the first structural element will be start any RCC structure. First to construct the footing, otherwise the next column, and otherwise that next beam and slab. These are the process of construction of RCC structure. The first footing is nothing but foundation. These are the different types of footings: stepped footings, ascended footings, and pedestals, rectangular or circular. These are the footings. Columns will be only, the columns are square shape or circular shape also used. Rectangular shape also used for columns. These shapes are used in RCC structures. Footings are also square footing, rectangular footings, isolated footings. These are the footings shapes are used in RCC structures. See, limit state, all the designs, note, see the note, all the designs to be thought in the limit state method. Okay, maximum all structural elements are used for limit state design, limit state philosophy. Okay, see the pattern, final examination. The pattern, see the end of examination paper should be consist of part A and part B. Part A consists of two questions in design and a drawing, out of which one question is to be answered. See, part A will be given two questions or given one choice. Two questions given, only one question will be answered. That is the part A. Another one, part B, should be consist of five questions. And design, out of which three are to be answered. See, part B, given totally five questions, part B, answer only three questions. That means weightage of part A is 40% and part B is 60%. This is the exam pattern for designing and drawing of reinforced concrete structures. Any structural element will be designed and draw the drawing also. Entire in giving the drawing sheets to examination, give the two drawing sheets, design after drawing the structural element in drawing sheet. Okay, this is the entire syllabus for as per JNTU Kakinada, design of reinforced concrete, design and drawing of reinforced concrete structures. This is the syllabus, entire syllabus. I will explain, see what is the, I go to next slide, what is beam, how to design. See the picture, entire, these are the beams. This is the horizontal member, beam nothing but, that is the horizontal member. This is the rectangular shape. The beams are rectangular shape. See the picture. This beam are designed in RCC structures. Just like due to reinforcement details about the beams. See this type of arrangement of beams for entire reinforcement details. Main bars and stirrups also will be designed. See what is the spacing. See the picture. These are the main reinforcement. This is the main reinforcement, another one. This is the stirrups. Giving the spacing, spacing also will be calculated for a design concept. Stirrup to stirrup, design the spacing. How much maximum will be in all these structures? The spacing maximum 300 mm. That is the maximum spacing of stirrups, 300 mm as per Indian standard. See, this is the entire beam reinforcement details. When this is the double reinforced beam. See, two zones are there. This is the compression zone. This is the tension zone. Both zones providing reinforcement, that is called double reinforced beams. Okay, only compression zone provide reinforcement, that is called single reinforced beam. See, go to next slide. Entire structure, see beams, columns, and footings. First footing, column, beam. See the picture, entire RCC structure. This arrangement of construction, this structural elements. Footings will, footing design and column design and beam design. See, go to next slide. Columns, see this picture. Rectangular columns and circular columns. Mainly high strength will be given for circular column compared to rectangular or square column. High strength, high bearing capacity give the column for circular columns will be preferred. Maximum bridges are will be bridges mainly bridges will be preferred for circular columns. Just like bridges, another name for using abutments, abutments are piers. That is just like column. These are the columns, vertical stirrups or cement concrete. See these two features, conjunction procedure of RCC column. These are the columns for designing the RCC structures. This is the picture. See, go to next slide. These are the footings. See different types of footings. But, the first one is stepper footing, another one is isolated footing. See entire wrapped step one, step two. That is the ground and then the wrapped thing. Step one, step two. This is the footing arrangement, how to design the footing. See the first picture, that is stepper footing. Another one is second picture, see isolated RCC footing. See reinforcement details and the column details. See the isolated footing, reinforcement details. These two types of footings, designing the RCC reinforced concrete structures. See, go to next slide. Slabs. See the arrangement of reinforcement details in slab. Slabs are two types, one-way slab and a two-way slab. See that these reinforcement details, these conditions, use only 8 mm and 10 mm bars are used for slab reinforcement. The diameter, the sizes of reinforcement bars 8 mm and 10 mm are reinforcement bars are only used in one way slab or two way slab. And see next to another one, the footing and the column reinforcement and the beam reinforcement bars are sizes. For beam sizes, beam reinforcement sizes will be start 12 mm, 16 mm, 20 mm, 25 mm will be taken for column reinforcement sizes. Another one, beams also taken for 16 mm, 20 mm, 25 mm reinforcement bars are taken for beam design. Another one is footing will be taken the reinforcement bars. See the footings, different types of footings, stepped footings and pedestal footings. These are the footings are used for RC structures. See another one, go to discuss about the slabs. There are reinforcement details for slab. There are two types of slabs, one way slab and two way slab. See that the diagrams are, see the picture, one way slab and two way slab. Compare it with these two slabs. See one way slab, two supports are there, support one, support two. Another one, go to two way slab. Two way slab, these are the four supports are there, support one, two, three, four supports are there. Two way slab, see comparison, these two slabs are will be designed in RCC structures just like a roof for the RCC structures. So one way slab and a two way slab. These are the types of slabs. See, next one, this is the diagram, workpieces methodology, how to design the beam, how to take in the design parameters or design concepts. See this stress strain diagram, how to design the beam using working stress methodology. This is the singly reinforced section. See, compression zone only provide reinforcement, that is called singly reinforced beam. This is the cross section of beam, rectangular beam, the cross section. See this picture, the stress and the strain diagram. See how two zones are there, compression zone and tension zone. Only provide compression zone, the main reinforcement will be provided, that is called a single reinforced section. See this last stress diagram. See, capital T means tension. Capital T means tension zone. Capital C, sorry, tension. This is the compression. Okay, sorry. Compression zone will be no reinforcement. This is the compression zone. This is the tension zone. Tension zone will be provided main reinforcement, that is called beam. And both tension zone and compression zone will provide reinforcement, that is called double reinforced beam. See this picture, only provide tension zone only. Tension zone only provide main reinforcement, that is called a single reinforced beam. See these parameters for a stress and a strain diagrams. And this is the compression zone, C equal to 1/2 sigma CB into B, or another one, cap small a is equal to JD. That means D minus N by 3. Capital T formula, sigma ST, capital E ST. That means this is the stress diagram and the strain diagram. The design parameters will be taken this diagram. How to design the modular ratio and moment of resistance. It should be calculate the formulas, this arrangement for single reinforced beam. Another one, double reinforced beam will be changed. The formula will be changed in the formula. One is singly double reinforced beams are entire different and different formulas, different parameters are there. This is only single reinforced section for given best example. For example, will be taken. Next class will be discussed about entire what is singly and what is doubly. What are the parameters? What is the model ratio? what is the reinforcement details will be explained later. See another one. Go to next slide. This is the limit state design, actual depth of lateral axis. See stress strain diagram, strain profile, stress profile. This is the limit state for a single reinforced section. Only provide tension zone, the reinforcement that is called single reinforced section, that is called single reinforced beam. This is a rectangular beam. See the cross section and strain diagram and stress diagram. See C1 and C2, that is the compression acting compressive stresses. C1 and C2, that is these are the compressive stresses. Both the combination capital CU, that is the C1 plus C2, that is the CU. Okay, and then strain. See the neutral axis. This is the neutral axis, dotted line. This is the neutral axis for beam center. That is the neutral axis. Overall depth means entire beam. That is our capital D overall depth. Small d means effective depth. That is the main reinforcement center to top compression zone of the top. This is the small d. That is the effective depth of the depth of the beam. Capital D means overall depth of the beam. This is the XU neutral axis and D minus X. This is the D minus overall small d. This is the XU. This means neutral axis neutral axis depth XU. See this philosophy. This is the philosophy of a limit state design. How to calculate the neutral axis depth? Okay, how to calculate the moment of resistance? This is the process for a limit state design, taking these values, strain value sigma C equal to 0.0035 as per standard, 0.45 FCK. FCK means stress for stress diagram. FCK means characteristic strength of concrete, and Fy means yield strength of steel. Fy means steel yield strength. Fy means yield strength. FCK means characterization of concrete. Okay, I will discuss about next class about the working stress method, methodology, and design parameters. What is model ratio? What is moment of resistance? Will be design two types of beams: singly reinforced beam and a doubly reinforced beam using working stress method. How to design the beams? How to calculate the empirical formulas in working stress method. Next class will be explained. First unit, first discussed about the working stress method, and first I will discuss methodologies. First of all, what are the methodologies? How to what is the methodology? What is the procedure about different methodology? What is the procedure about the methodologies? I will discuss. Okay. I will discuss next class. This is the entire class will be discussion about the syllabus, entire syllabus for the JNTU Kakinada RCC structures. What are the parameter structure elements? Design the entire RCC structures. The syllabus for as per JNTU Kakinada University. See this course will be learned and design the entire elements. Okay, any doubts? Please tell me, ask me any doubts. I will explain.